Coming up, we take a closer look at Microsoft Teams, the latest addition to Office 365 that makes it easier for you to chat in groups, socialize, and collaborate. We'll walk through the experience of chatting, sharing files, and hosting online meetings, plus how your teams can connect to external services. And if you're an IT admin, we're going to show you how you can configure Microsoft Teams for your organization. Today by Dan Stevenson, one of the product leaders for Microsoft Teams. Welcome.
Thanks for having me.
So when you think about Office 365, it's really built for collaboration. We've got applications that span email, file sharing, social, and communications. But what changes with Microsoft Teams?
Well, that's right, Jeremy. Office has a bunch of different options for collaboration. And then with Microsoft Teams, we're bringing all these tools together with a real focus on how people work together in a team. We start with chat. We build it around chat. Chat's this really effective, natural way for teams to communicate. It's fast, it's friendly, it's informal. And then around that, we have files from your SharePoint team site. We have notes from OneNote. We have Planner, so you can have project plans from Microsoft Planner. We even pulled in your Exchange calendar. So it comes all together in this chat-centered team workspace that persists over time.
So it's really a great hub for teamwork, but how easy is it to set up the experience?
It's actually really simple to get going. Let me show you. So here I am on the Office 365 homepage, and you see we have a tile for Teams in the app launcher. Go ahead and click on that, and I'm going to open up the Teams web app, which you can also get to by going to teams.microsoft.com. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm a new user in this web app, and so in the upper right there, I have a button to download the desktop client. We can go ahead and click that. I actually prefer to use the desktop client. It gives me single sign-on, better caching, better performance. We have clients for Mac. We also have clients for Windows and Android and iPhone. Okay. Now, I've got the client already installed on my machine, so I'm just going to go over to my other desktop here, go to Start, Teams. Up comes the desktop app, and here I am in Microsoft Teams. On the left side, you can see that I've got a main navigation bar here with activity, chats, teams, meetings, and files. Mm-hmm. Down this column here, I've got all the different teams I'm on, including channels. Now, channels are this really convenient way to organize the different messages within a team. You might have a couple teams. Within each team, you might have a few channels. It really depends on how things go and what the culture of the team is. If there's an unread message in a channel, it shows up as bold. And if I'm at mentioned or a message is sent as important or if there's a meeting going on, other decorations show up as well, which I'll talk about in a second.
Okay.
Let's go in and see how easy it is to chat. So let's just send a quick chat message here. I'm going to send hello world, send that out. And then thing you notice right away is at the bottom of every message, there's a reply button. So I can reply here, I can reply to any other message, and we have this simple threading built in right away. Now, if I really like this message, looks like a few people have beat me to the punch, I can click the thumbs up and like it. Let's say I want to make sure you're actually paying attention, Jeremy, because, you know, I know you might not be.
And I'm not.
You're absolutely not. So I'm going to mention you. And here we go. At Jeremy. And it auto-completes from my address book. And I send you an at mention. And then on your screen.
I see my notification here in the lower right-hand corner. I click on that. Are you there? Yes, I am. But I see here there's a bookmark icon that says save. What do I do with that?
Well, go ahead and click that, and it's going to save it into a favorites in the upper left. Okay. I also see that you're modeling the dark theme there. That's a personal choice. It's pretty popular with a lot of folks on our own development team, actually. So I can also use rich text for more formal posts. You know, something where I want to say, give it a subject, put in some bulleted lists, some numbers, things like that. So I took my daughter to the state fair the other day, and she went sheep riding. So
sounds
we
like
had
fun.
Oh, it was awesome. So we had some rules for that. Hold on tight, hold on tighter, just in case, wear body armor. And this is a pretty important message, so I'm going to mark that as important as well. This is really convenient for when you want to send something a little more than just a short blurb back and forth. And you also see, as things are going by on my screen, that I'm getting notifications, I'm getting at mentions, everything is badged and easy to find for me.
So that smiley face that we saw in terms of the replies and some of that dialogue there, is that just a set of emojis?
Oh, it's a lot more than that. Let's take a look. So we've got emojis, of course, but we also have animated GIFs. We have stickers that you can caption, all sorts of things. Let's grab some stickers. We'll get this happy robot here, and we'll say something exciting about Microsoft Teams is great. All right, let's drop that right in there. All right, this is it's not just for fun. It's actually part of the social dynamics in a team. It goes beyond just plain text on a screen. It makes it a little more fluid and informal and friendly for a team to get together and really work in a chat environment.
Looks like a really great set of experiences to start chatting and really share ideas with your team members, but how do I go about actually collaborating on a set of docs?
Yeah. So I'm going to switch to the partner marketing event channel here, and you can already see there's some files have been uploaded. But let's grab another one in there. So I'm going to go to my OneDrive for Business, And I've got a tips for Microsoft Teams file that I want to share with everybody. Put a quick message on it if I want. And send it. Now, that file got posted into the chat, but it did a lot more than that. It actually got uploaded to a SharePoint team site that we create every time we create a team because we're based on Office 365 groups. Within that team site, we have a folder for every channel. And in that folder, I'll go up here and click on files. You can see all the files that have been uploaded for that channel. Now, let's go a little further here. I think these tips are pretty important. Everybody should be reading them. So I'm going to actually click on that and make it into a tab. And what that's going to do is add it across the top there, right next to conversation files and notes. Now, anytime anybody comes into this channel, they see that pin there. This is a great way for me to personalize the channel, personalize the team, just for me, just for my team.
So you've pinned a file, and your files are basically going to a doc library in SharePoint that's been created for that channel. But I see notes here as well.
Yeah, we sure do. So we've got notes where you can go into OneNote, and I can create a notebook page. You know, perhaps I want to create something about a marketing plan that we have coming up. I can edit that in here. It's a really nice web editor we built straight in to Microsoft Teams, or I can open it up in OneNote. So a few more tab options we have here as well, of course. I can add Planner here. I can add Power BI, any Office document, SharePoint Doc Library, and a lot more coming soon that we can add in there.
So earlier I noticed there was a video icon. What does that do?
Yeah, so that's for meetings, of course. I can click on that, and I start an ad hoc meeting in the channel. I'm going to go ahead and start that up here. And anybody who's in the channel, or actually in Microsoft Teams, in my team, is going to see a notification that there's a meeting going on. Now, they're not automatically joined to it, but I can click on somebody and bring them in. So I'll bring you in. I'll see if a couple other folks can join here. We've got a bunch of people joining in here. Up to actually four videos will show side by side, and then if more people join, we'll have more over time. If people chat in the meeting, we'll see that those chat messages show up. And then once I hang up, I have this record of the meeting in my chat history. So I can go back and see if there were notes that were taken or there were documents that were shared or anything like that. It shows up in the history for that meeting.
This looks like a really easy way to spin up impromptu meetings, but what if I want to schedule a meeting?
Yeah, so we've got that too. I'm going to go over here and click on meetings, and it's pulling all my meetings down from my Exchange calendar. I can click to join a meeting if it's online in Skype for Business or in Microsoft Teams. And if I want to create a new meeting, all I do is click this button down here and it schedules a new meeting within Microsoft Teams.
So everything here by default is shared with the team, but what if I don't want to share with everyone on the team and just have one-on-one conversations or chat with external users?
Yeah, so a lot of work actually does happen in smaller conversations. Let's go over here to chats. You can see I've got a bunch of one-on-one chats going on, even group chats. Got one going on with you here. You can see that it works very similarly to the channel conversation we had within the team. In fact, I've got the same kind of workspace built around my one-on-one chats. I've got files and notes. I can see an org chart. I can even see an activity feed of everything you've done in Microsoft Teams. And in the top right, of course, I can do an ad hoc video call or audio call with you.
Great stuff. So what if I want to bring in another service into the team chat?
Yeah, so that fits really well with our hub model. We start with chat. Around that, we have files, notes, and tabs. And then we have connectors, which lets you bring in external services. So let me go over here, back into my event channel here, and I'm going to click on dot, 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 and go to connectors. And you see here I have a list of all the different connectors we have available. A lot of these are for development teams, Visual Studio, GitHub, that kind of thing. We also have some fun ones or more general purpose ones like Twitter and Bing News.
Great list of connectors that you have there, but how easy is it to pull that into my feed?
Yeah, so I'm going to just add a Twitter one here. Let's go ahead and get that going here. Now, what's your Twitter handle there?
MSFT Mechanics.
All right. And let's grab your mentions and retweets.
Okay.
And we'll do this as soon as they come in so we know the moment something's going on in the Twitterverse that impacts Microsoft Mechanics. We'll save that. Close out of here. And you can see we already started getting some coming in. Here's one about migrating your OneDrive for Business files and a couple other posts as well that came in.
Does this work also on a mobile device?
Yeah, it sure does. Let me show you here. So here I am on my phone. I've got my alerts. I've got chats on my private one-on-one and group chats. I've got my Teams. So if I want to bring something up in a channel, I can do that. And then I even have files. So if I want to bring up a file, I got it right there within the app, Microsoft Teams on my phone. And of course, with push notifications, I'm never more than a buzz or a ring away from my team.
So really great for keeping up with your team on the go. But switching gears for a second, what's the story for IT admins? I know a lot of people are watching today that are admins. What kind of controls have you put in place in terms of managing the implementation and the rollout of Microsoft Teams?
Yeah, well, we didn't forget our admins. First, Microsoft Teams is part of the Office 365 suite plans, like Business Premium and E3. Second, as I said earlier, we're built on top of Office 365 Groups, which gives us a lot of IT capabilities right out of the box. We've got an admin UI, and I'll show you here. I'm in the O365 homepage. I'm going to click on Admin, and I'm going to go into the Office 365 Admin Center, and under Services and Add-ins over here, and down there at the bottom of the screen, you see Microsoft Teams. Go ahead and open that up, and this is the very important first step you need to take. During our preview period, we're off by default, so we want to make sure that everybody turns us on and starts using Microsoft Teams within their company. Now, we have a few more settings, of course. You can do things like manage the showing of the org chart, notifications, feedback. If you want to manage who can actually create a group, you actually go to the Office 365 Groups control panel. Because we're based on O365 Groups, we get a lot of benefits from that. Say you want to decide whether or not you can have screen sharing or video in a meeting. We have some settings for that. And then in messaging, you know, we know that people like these the GIFs and the stickers and the memes, but it may not be for every team. So we give you some options to turn those on or off. I always like to turn them on, of course. And you can do a content rating depending on the sensitivities within your company. We have a tab switch, so you can decide whether or not you want to allow tabs to show up. And then down here, we have some settings that let you configure bots.
What are the bots about?
Yeah, so bots in Microsoft Teams let you interact with apps and services directly from a chat. We're working with companies like Poly, MeCam, and StatSpot, to name just a few. And you'll see these lighting up in Microsoft Teams over the coming months. Our help system is actually also a bot called T-Bot. You should try and chat up T-Bot if you have any questions. Bots are also a great way for any developer to integrate a service directly into Microsoft Teams using the Microsoft Bot Framework. We could probably go on another 20 minutes just on that.
For those viewers at home interested in terms of security and compliance, policies that we're meeting, kind of the controls there, what are we doing for Microsoft Teams?
Yeah, so we're part of Office 365, so we're covered by the O365 compliance framework. That includes things like SOC 2. And then because we're based on SharePoint and OneDrive for Business, you get all the security and compliance controls that you already have for files. For chat messages, we're working on archiving and e-discovery via Exchange.
So what else can we expect? What are you working on in the future in terms of taking Microsoft Teams further?
Well, we just launched, but we're constantly updating Microsoft Teams. We're working on better support for different types of teams and organizations and lots more. We're also going to be announcing a lot more integrations via tabs, connectors, and bots, both from Microsoft and our partners over the coming months.
It's really useful stuff. I'm watching this at home. How can I try this out?
Yeah, so first thing is, if you're an admin, turn on Microsoft Teams for your tenant, just like I showed you. Then to use it, look for the tile on the Office homepage. Or better yet, point your browser to teams.microsoft.com. Get your team together and get started. Our preview is available worldwide in 19 different languages. For more info, check out the link below.
It's a really great overview, Dan. Thanks for joining us today. And also, don't forget to keep checking back to Microsoft Mechanics for the latest in tech updates. Thanks for watching, and goodbye for now.